Today we will discuss about the cecum. It is the commencement of the large intestine or beginning of the large intestine. It is situated into the right iliac fossa, just above to the lateral half of the inguinal ligaments. So it is situated into the right iliac fossa. It is the commencement of the large intestine. It is a characteristic. It has a more a breadth than the length. So it is nearly 7.5 centimeter in breadth, and length it is 6 centimeter. It is situated into the right iliac fossa. This is the ileocecal junction. This is the ileocecal junction, and ostromedially, here this is the appendix. Here I will show you. This is the appendix. Nearly, this is a very small appendix. It is the diameter nearly 20 centimeter in length. But normally the appendix, it is the retrocecal in positions. But this is the appendix which is positioned either into the 3 o'clock positions, 3 o'clock position or a pelvic position of the appendix. This is the ileocecal junction. It has a two flap of the wall at the ileocecal junction. One flap which is the lower flap, and one is the upper flap. Lower flap, it is the junction of the at the ileocecal, and the upper flap which is at the ileocolic junction. So this upper flap, it is a continuation of the ascending colon. Cecum become continuous as an ascending colon, and the lower flap, it is the junction of the ileum and cecum. So it is called the ileocecal junctions. The cecum, which is developed from the cecal buds, it developed from the cecal buds. It has a proximal part which is dilated and it forms the cecum, and distal part which is retained as it is, and it is not dilated and it forms the appendix. And mostly the both the right and left cecal bud, which is equally developed, then it is a conical in shape. And normally the left cecal bud, which is more developed as compared to the right cecal buds, so right cecal bud, which is more developed, it is called the ampullary type of the cecum. Here in our case it is the ampullary type because the appendix lies on the medial aspect. So it is the ampullary type, and it is the most common. It is the 78%. And the conical type, it is the 13% when the appendix which is arise from the middle part, it's called the conical. And the ampullary, it is the most common, as ampullary is the most common, and intermediate type when the cecal bed developed both the equally, but it is, there is a biconcave, and the appendix which is lies from the middle part. So this is about to the type of the cecum: conical, ampullary, and intermediate. Most common is the ampullary. It is when the right cecal bud, which is more developed than the left cecal bud, at that time appendix which is lies on the medial aspect, it is called the ampullary. It is the 78%. Conical, it is the 13%, and the intermediate, it is a 9% of the cecums. The relation of the cecum: anteriorly it is related with the coil of the intestine and anti-abdominal wall. Here you can see there is a cecum which is lies anteriorly, coil of the small intestine and anti-abdominal wall. Posteriorly, we can see here, you can see posteriorly it is related with the psoas major muscles, and also there is a presence of the quadratus lumborus muscles. And there are three nerves which is on that right side we have not dissected, but on the left side we have dissected. There are three nerves. One is the genitofemoral, one is the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh and femoral nerve. These are the three nerves which is lies on the posterior aspect of the cecum. Now I have dissected the on the right side. I will show you, this is the genito femoral nerve over the psoas major muscles, and this is the lateral cutaneous nerve of the thigh, and just medial to just lateral to the psoas major it is a femoral nerve. So these are the three nerves which lies posterior to the cecum, and also this muscle, it is the iliacus and psoas major, both muscles which is lies posterior to the cecum. And there is one artery here, you can see this is a testicular artery which is lies, or it is called the gonadal artery, which is lies posterior to the cecum. So these are the relations of the cecum on the posterior aspect. We already discussed the iliocecal wall. We have not here dissected the iliocecal wall and not open, but I will show you, this is the ilium, this is the terminal part of the ilium which is open inside the cecum. So this is the lower part of the lower, where there is a junction of the cecum and ilium, it is called the iliocecal flap of the wall, and above there is a ascending colon and there is a ilium, it is called the upper lip, it is formed by the upper lip which is attached at the junction of the iliopolyp. So there are two frenula, lower and upper. Lower one it is at junction of the iliocecal, and upper one it is a iliopolyp junctions. So the cecum become continuous as a ascending colon, and the main function of this iliocecal wall to prevent the reflux from the cecum to the ileum. So it is a one-way wall. Once the content of the ileum which is goes inside the cecum, then the food, it is called the stool, so it is a fecal material, and the most of the absorption which is occur inside the up to the ileum or small intestine, so it prevent the reflux and also regulate the content of the ileum which is gradually goes inside the cecum. It is the main function of the iliocecal wall. Now we will discuss about the appendix. It is the worm-like diverticulum arise from the posteromedial part of the cecum. It is the appendix. Here you can see this is the appendix, and I will put into the positions. So it is nearly horizontal in there are different variety of the positions of the appendix. Whenever it is a retrocolic, means the appendix which is passes behind to the cecum, it is the 12 o'clock position, it is called the retrocolic position. It is a 65%, it is a around 65% it is a retrocolic. If the cecum which is goes towards the on the upper side and left side, and then it is called the splenic, it is a 2 o'clock position, it is called the splenic. Either it may be from the pre-ileal or post-ileal. The pre-ileal, it is the most dangerous variety of the appendix. Another is the 3 o'clock position. This is the nearly 3 o'clock positions, and 3 o'clock positions, which is also called the position, it is called the towards the sacral promontory. It is the towards the sacral promontory, which is goes here, there is a position of the sacrum, so it is towards the sacral promontory. If the 4 o'clock position, which is goes downwards, then it is called the pelvic positions. Then it is called the, if it is goes downwards, my forceps direction, then it is called the pelvic position. It is the 4 o'clock positions. And sometimes there is a, it goes at the 6 o'clock positions, towards the mid inguinal ligaments. It is the 6 o'clock position, it is a mid inguinal position. So these are the different position of the appendix. And also there is a, sometimes it is a retrocecal, but it at the 11 o'clock position, at the 11 o'clock positions. So the appendix, which is guarded by the one fold of the wall, it is called the, this wall, it is called the fold of the mucosa, it is the wall, it is called the garlic wall. It is a garlic wall, and sometimes there is a inflammation, fecal material goes inside the appendix, then it lead to there is a appendicitis, and the appendicitis normally it lead to there is a severe pain, there is a fever, vomiting which occurs, and this lead to there is a presence of the Trillenberg signs. There is a positive Trillenberg sign. It is the anterior iliac spine to the umbilicus. You have to draw the line, and lateral 1/3 and medial 2/3. Lateral 1/3 and medial 2/3 junction. It is the McBurney's point where there is a maximum tenderness which occurs. It is a sign of the appendicitis. So it is the appendicitis. It is the most common occur into the children age 15 to 25 years of the age. So this is about to the appendix. Hope you enjoy the lecture of the appendix and cecum. Thank you. I have just reflected the appendix and cecum on the, here you can see this is a continuation of the iliopolic artery, and this iliopolic artery which gives the appendicular artery. Here you can see this is the appendicular artery. So this appendicular artery which supplies to the appendix from the iliopolic artery, and this is a mesoappendix. It is a fold of the peritoneum. Normally it is not extend up to the tip of the appendix, but up to the 2/3 part from the base of the cecum, 2/3 part which is extend the mesoappendix, and it contains the appendicular vessels. So this is the blood supply by the appendicular artery. It is a branch of the iliopolic artery. Now supply by the sympathetic by the T9 and T10, and parasympathetic which is supplied by the branches coming from the vagus nerve, and the lymphatic which is the iliopolic lymph nodes. Here you can see this is a iliopolic lymph node. These are the lymph node which is drained by the appendix. So this is about to the appendix and cecum. Thank you.